Hello, fans, and welcome to This Day in Baseball, where we're going to bring you a full radio broadcast of today's game. And before we do that, I just want to thank Classic Baseball Radio, and there's a link in the notes where you can check out their full channel. They have many, many great radio broadcasts. And while you're listening to today's game, if you want to check out much more about the game and the players, look on the links below, and you're going to see links to player pages, the date the game happened, the year it happened, and the play-by-play. Enjoy the game, and check out the links while you're watching the game, and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button so that every time new content comes out, you're going to get that firsthand. And thank you again for checking out This Day in Baseball, and enjoy the game.
Play-by-play description of the fifth game of the 1936 World Series is brought to you with the compliments of the Ford Motor Company, Mr. Henry Ford, Mr. Ansel Ford, and your local Ford and Lincoln Tucker dealer. Your play-by-play announcer for the fifth game of the World Series will be Bob Elson. Now I'm going to turn the microphone over to Neutral's eighth commentator, Gabriel Heater of WOR Newark.
Thank you, Tony Wakeman. Good afternoon, everyone. Well, it's do or die for Bill Terry and his Giants today. It's Armageddon. Another victory for the Yankees in the World Series of 1936 will be another chapter for the winter book, the Hot Stove League of Poignant Memories. What a victory would put the Giants in the running again, and everyone in this great stadium seems to sense that we're standing at the crossroads or sitting. Mr. Terry stands today where Horatio stood at the bridge, where Jeff stood at the mound, where Jack Dempsey stood as he crawled back into the ring after the wild bull of the Pampas had tossed him out. He's on his own 2-yard line. It's make or break. And which of these it's to be, the next 2 hours may tell. Listening in on the average fan in his seat, you hear two schools of opinion today. Here's one of them. When you beat Hubble, you beat the Giants. When Hubble can't win, no one can. The dynamite in those Yankee bats will write the word finish today to the baseball saga of 36. But for everyone who talks that way, I hear another who says the Giants are best when they're fighting with their backs to the wall. Crowd them and they fight. That's how they won the pennant in their own league. Best when the umpires counted nine. When the fates are ready to draw the curtain. When the forecasters say it's all over but the shouting. Then watch those Giants. And there you have it, the affirmative and the negative. The American League and the National, the Harlem Hooters and the Bronx in game number 5. Play the game today, the stands would show thousands of vacant seats. This must be a sad day for speculators. Even the rooftops, which were jammed yesterday, are all covered with Monday morning watch. Where hundreds hung on for dear life yesterday, today there are nightgowns, underwear, table linen hanging under a hazy sky. And that riotous applause you hear now is all for the gentleman known as Al Schott. Today, Al is putting on a new act. He went way out to center field, put on a raincoat instead of his swallowtail, a gray fedora instead of the battered high hat, flanked by two special officers on his right and left, followed by the band. He comes marching down triumphantly to take hands with Mayor LaGuardia. And it does make a funny spectacle. Al and the mayor, and he puts the mayor's hat on now. The mayor puts his glasses back over his curly black head. The mayor stands up and whispers something to Al. Al whispers back, puts his hand affects something around them. Now they make a field day for the photographer. Al, like some distinguished visitor, coming to pay his respects to New York, and the mayor reaching in his pocket for something, must be the keys to the city. No, it's just his glasses, and it is a field day for everybody in the stand. It's a bit of life we need here. Because, frankly, this was a dull, gray, dreary morning before game time. For the first time, there were bleacher seats going begging. Maybe it's Blue Monday, maybe it's the Yankee runaway. Whichever it is, there was a funereal quiet here during practice, which made a strange contrast to yesterday. Only a few days ago, hundreds were lined up all night to buy the price of something. We've had drama of all kinds here and at the Polo Grounds. Hubble in the rain, Gomez making his slightly erratic but sensational comeback. Simmons fighting every inch and putting on, to my mind, the best pitching exhibition we've had here. Pearson yesterday taking all the punch out of giant bats. Lou Gehrig's powerful shoulder sailing in to beat a ball and sending it sailing to the land from which there's no returning. Sambo Leslie coming in twice as a pinch hitter and making good each time. We've had miracle catches and incredible stops, yet somehow this moment now seems to be the most impressive of all. Underlying it, over it all, you feel a sense of hushed expectancy. Yankee rooters know that one more game spells world champion. Giant rooters know that one more game puts them into the running again. And now we're almost ready. Pitchers warming up. Bats which came out on wheelbarrows stacked high. A half dozen boxes of new balls for which fans fight as they might for home and mother. And the groundskeeper army in brown doing its own final stuff. I tried to check with a number of experts, and I find a universal agreement among writers and old fans. The umpires in this series have been doing a workmanlike job. While we're on the subject of workmanlike jobs, I'm going to ask my friend Walter Winchell to toss one of his choice orchids to the New York City Police Department for their job. A job in handling a record-breaking crowd and doing it well. 50,000 at the Polo Ground, 65,000 here yesterday. Thousands turned away outside, yet there wasn't a time when anyone or anything was jammed. Traffic moved, all the police are polite, everyone smiled. There's no crowding, it's an admirable job and well done. And now, with a song in their hearts and a prayer on their lips and a do or die in their eyes, Yanks and Giants take the final drink. The new stick of gum, which goes in as the practice stick comes out, and I suppose looking down into the Yankee stadium, both Giant and Yankee side, the stronger boys take something which looks like an old-fashioned chew instead of chewing gum. And the clock in center field tolls its fatal minute. What the day will bring, time alone will tell. Everything seems to depend on Hal and his ability to silence those Yankee bats. Maybe Hal will prove to be the man to do it. And for the Yankees, roughing the red. The man who came out of the Black Diamond Empire of Old King Gold with a splendid career on the baseball diamond. There are many experts here who feel that Ruffing pitched a fine game in the opener against trouble. Far better even than the final score shows. And maybe he's going to turn in another today with better luck. However, we're almost ready for game time, and I'm going to turn you over to Bob Elson, the WGN, who gives you those dramatic close-ups of play-by-play on the field. Bob Elson.
Thank you, Gabe. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We're talking to you now from right up here above the home plate in a section of the press stand at the Yankee Stadium in New York City. Gabe has given you his usual colorful description of all the preliminaries, and they're setting here for the fifth game of the World Series between the Giants and the Yankees. The umpires are down here in front of us, right near the home plate. The pitchers are Schumacher, a right-hander for the Giants, and Ruffing, a right-hander for the Yankees. The photographer is getting a picture now of the captains, Jackson and Gehrig, with the umpires and the field announcers. The umpires today will be Furman, who did such a splendid job in the rain back at the plate the first day. At first, Dice of American League at first today with Furman back at the plate. Major Kurtz at second and Summers at third. Now the batting order for the Giants. Moore in left field, Bartell at short, Perry first, Ott in right, Ripple center, Mancuso catching, Whitehead second, Jackson third, and Schumacher pitching for the Yankees. Corsetti short, Rolfe at third, DiMaggio center, Gehrig at first, Dickey the catcher, Selkirk in right, Powell in left, Missouri at second, and Ruffing will do the pitching. Well, the Giants are all ready to go to bat now for the fifth game of the 1936 World Series, broadcast with the compliments of the Ford Motor Company and the Ford and Lincoln Zephyr dealers of America. We have another ideal day for the ball game today. It's a perfect setting. New York Giants really have their backs to the wall today, and it's do or die, now or never. They dropped this game today. The complete 1936 World Series is history.
Joe Moore is the first man up. A lot of empty seats up here on the upper deck today. It'll take a giant victory to really restore that intense interest that there was here in New York in those first three games. Now the series stands 3-1. Here's the first pitch of the ball game. Over the plate, and he whacks it. Trail hit down the left field line. It's hitting the barrier out there. Joe's rounding first base. He's on his way to second. He slides, and he stays at second. He started his slide that time, but as he started to go down, he saw that he could make it without the slide, and so naturally, a player usually doesn't slide unless he has to, because there's always a chance of an injury. Moore stayed up and gets into second base standing up. It's a two-bagger off of Ruffing right down the third baseline. The ball hits inside the bag about 2 feet, sharps it on the ground. Here's Bartell up. That's Moore's third hit of the series. Bartell, a right-handed hitter, facing Ruffing. Rolf has gone in close, expecting a sacrifice here. Lou Gehrig at first base is playing in a little bit. The pitch, fastball, low and outside, a ball. Joe Moore leads off with a nice double down the third baseline. Powell got over to the railing first in a hurry, played the ball on the rebound off out there and got it back in a hurry, but Moore goes into second base standing up. Now Ruffing is getting a sign again. The next pitch, Bartell swung at and fouled right back into the screen. Count is ball one and strike one for Bartell. Joe Moore on second base. Nobody out. First half of the first inning of this, the fifth game of the World Series. The pitchers are Ruffing, a right-hander, and Schumacher, a right-hander. Schumacher started once before, you know. Didn't have his control and was wrapped out of the box. Now Ruffing is ready. Here's the next pitch. Bartell drives one down the right field line. It's a safe hit. The ball is rolling out there against the wall. Bartell is bounding, coming into second base. The run is scored. It's a two-bagger for Bartell, scoring another run. And the Giants are leading here. Two doubles, one down the left field line and one down the right field line. That one was hit down the right field line. A line drive over Gehrig's head. It hit out there about 20 feet inside the line, rolled back and off the barrier. Selkirk played the ball fast on the rebound and got it back in, but it was too late. It's a two-bagger scoring a run. Looks like these Giants mean business here today. Here's Perry up. Left-handed hitter. Now Ruffing is getting ready. First pitch is a nice curve right in there around his knees for a called strike. And on second base, a run in from the Giants. Ruffing is getting a sign now. Here's the next pitch. Powell back into the stand. It looked like Bill, from the way he moved his feet that time, was trying to place the ball in the left field. Perry backs up. That was Bartell's sixth hit in the series. He doubled, scoring Moore. Ruffing looks back around the infield to see that everybody's in place. The Giants are batting. First half of the first inning. Ruffing is ready to pitch again to Perry. He swung at a curveball right around his waist and struck out. Perry struck out. One gone. It brings up Mellott. Here's Mellott up. Mell has made four hits in the series. Run is scored. Bartell is on second. Al is up at the plate. Perry went down on strike. Ruffing is getting a sign. I've looked at the first pitch. It's low and outside for a ball. Ball one. Powell in left field. DiMaggio in center. Selkirk in right. Selkirk is playing deep. DiMaggio is playing plenty deep. The infielder is playing in normal position, playing back. This is getting ready again. Here's the next pitch to Ott. Hit the ground ball through the box. The shortstop is behind second base. Up with him over to first base, and he's out. Corsetti to Gehrig. It advances Bartell to third. Mellott hit a sharp ground ball through the box, but Corsetti was playing him over close to the bag. Moved over hurriedly behind the bag, picked up the ball, and fired it over to Gehrig to get his man. Short to first, ball to second out. Here's Whipple. In the meantime, of course, Bartell advanced to third in the play. Here's Whipple. He's made three hits in the series, a home run and two singles. Now Ruffing is ready to pitch to him. First pitch, he hits foul down the third baseline. Ripple slashed the liner down the third baseline into the lower box seat, but foul. Thurman of the National League is the umpire-in-chief today, back at the plate. Summers of the American League at third, Major Kurth, National at second, and Geisel, American League at first.
Ruffing is ready to pitch again to Ripple. Hits a Texas Leaguer into left field. It's a hit, scoring another run for the Giants. Ripple comes up with a Texas Leaguer into left field, scoring another run for the Giants, and they're leading 2-0 now. Ripple dropped his Texas Leaguer in front of Powell in left field, who moved in fast for the ball, but couldn't get it in time. No chance of a play. Just threw the ball into second base to hold Ripple on first, and it brings up Mancuso, the catcher. Now there's a man on first base. Here's Gus up. First pitch, he hits one safely into right field, the ground ball. There's a man on first base. Ripple rolling around second base on his way to third, and he's safe at third. Mancuso slashed the ground ball to Gehrig's right into right field. It puts runners on first and third now for the Giants. And the next man to come up is Whitehead, who as yet has not made a hit in the series. That was Mancuso's fourth hit in the series. Well, the Giants starting off as though they mean business out here today. And they have to. It's now or never. Man on first, a man on third. Here's the second baseman, Burgess Whitehead up, facing Ruffing. Two runs are in. There's a drive, foul down the first baseline. A low liner hit foul by Whitehead. One strike. Now the new ball is tossed into the game. Ruffing takes his glove off, drops the ball up in his hand. The Giants have scored two runs here in their half of the first inning. There's two out, and they have runners on first and third. Ruffing opposing Schumacher. Red's getting his sign again. Here's the next pitch to Whitehead. There's a hard hit in the right field by Whitehead. Scoring another run. Mancuso stops at second. He smashed a hit, a low liner about waist high between Gehrig and Lazzari into right field. Three runs are in now, and the Giants have runners on first and second. Next man to come up is Jackson. That's the fifth hit of the inning. That is Whitehead's first hit of the series. Three runs and five hits. Yankees are in a huddle out there now. Gary, draws for over talking to Ruffing. Next man to come up is Jackson. Whitehead on first. Mancuso on second. Already out there now. Jackson hits a high fly to left center. DiMaggio's going way back. He's going to get under it. He's under it now, and he has it retiring the side. Two men are left on the bases, and that's the end of the first half of the first inning.
Well, the New York Giants are on the field. Joe Moore in left field. Jim Ripple in center. Mel out in right. Joe is just walking into left field now, adjusting his glasses. Jackson's on third. Bartell on short. Second base is Burgess Whitehead, who just made his first hit of the series. And Bill Terry, the manager, is on first. Gus Mancuso is the catcher. And Hal Schumacher, a very fine right-hander when he's right, is the pitcher. First effort in the series, he wasn't right. He couldn't control that sinker of his. And consequently, he was getting himself in the hole and had to throw one right down the middle, and the boys were clowning it. Now the first man to bat is Corsetti. The Giants came up with three runs in their half of the inning. Here's Corsetti up. He's made seven hits in the series. Right-handed batter. Now the wind-up in the pitch. Fastball low and inside. A ball to Frankie. Looks like he was going to bunt the ball. He had his bat shortened, but the pitch was a little bit too low, and he stayed away from it. Schumacher wipes his hands in the front of his uniform. Gets ready out there now. Now the wind-up in the next pitch to Corsetti. A fastball right around his knees. A call strike. The count is one and one. Ball one and strike one. Corsetti registers a mild squawk on the pitch. Frank is back in the batter's box now. Pulls his cap down firmly on his head. It's already out there. Schumacher winding up. Here comes the next pitch. There's a ball a little bit outside, just above the knee. Ball two is strike one.
The umpires, by the way, have done a very fine job in this series. Their work has been all that could be desired. Winding up again, here's the next pitch. He swung a fastball and missed it, right on his knee. Schumacher threw in the dark one that time. Frankie Corsetti swung from his heels and missed it. And the count is 2-2. Frankie's played some swell ball in this series. Great game at short, and he's done some fine hitting with 7 hits. Schumacher's getting his sign again. There's the start of his motion. Here comes the next pitch. Strike three. Struck him out. He threw in the sinker right in around his knee. A quick stop on the ball, and he's out for the first out. Corsetti was called out on strike. Here's the third baseman, Red Ruffing. He's made 5 hits in the series. Ruffing up. He's up left-handed. Here's the wind-up on the pitch. Fastball right over the plate. Knee high. It's called strike. Nobody on the bases for the Yankees. One out. Last half of the first inning. The Giants scored 3 runs in their half of the inning on 5 hits off of Ruffing. Schumacher winds up again. The next pitch. Fastball. He hits a long fly ball in the left center. Center fielder is over. In. And he has the ball. Beautiful dive and catch by Ruffing. Was playing and way over in right center field, and he had to move over into left center very fast. The ball dropped hurriedly, and Whipple made a beautiful dive for the ball and came up with it to get the call for the second out. It was the second beautiful fielding play that Whipple has made in the series. Whipple was playing well in deep right center. He had to move over fast into left center, and the ball dropped hurriedly. He was moving in fast. He made a dive for the ball and caught it. The ball was still plenty far out for the second out. It was a beautiful play by Jim Ripple, the Giants center fielder. Here's DiMaggio, and the first pitch is wide at the knee for a ball. 0-1.
Some of those balls, some of those pitches, the way they're hit, depending on the stuff on the ball, they take an awful funny motion after they start out there in the air. That ball dropped hurriedly. It hit very hard. Winding up again, here's the next pitch to Joe. Right over the plate. Ball strike. Joe DiMaggio has 5 hits in the series. Ball one and strike one on Joe. Two out and nobody on the bases. Here's the windup in the next pitch. Fastball low and inside. A ball makes it ball two and strike one. Giants have Jackson on third. Bartell on short. Whitehead at second, Perry first, out in right, Ripple center, Joe Moore in left, Mancuso catching, and Hal Schumacher is the pitcher. This is the fifth game of the World Series. The Giants are ahead 3-0. Pitchy hits a bounding ball. Jackson at third. Going to be close. There goes over to first base. He's out. Perry made a one-handed stab of Jackson's high throw. Jackson had to move to his left for a high bounding ball. The ball was hit so hard that Jackson had to back up so he'd have that bounce timed perfectly. He caught it off a high bounce, got it over to first base, a high throw, and Perry made a nice stab to retire the side. All right, Tony.
Ripple gets the grand hand from the crowd as he comes in. Corsetti was the first man up for the New York Yankees. He struck out. Then Ripple made a beautiful running dive to get Rolfe's drive. And that made it 2-2. DiMaggio followed, and he went out Jackson to Perry to retire the side. We're going in now to the giant half of the second inning. And score is the New York Giants 3 and the Yankees nothing. Okay, Bob.
Now the Yankees are on the field. First man to bat for the Giants will be the pitcher, Hal Schumacher. Here's Hal selecting a bat down here below us. Moving up toward the plate now. Getting a hand from the crowd. You can hear it in your radio. Hal Schumacher, right-handed batter, is the first man to face Ruffing, who was capped for 5 hits and 3 runs in the first inning by the Giants. Now we're starting the second inning with the score, the Giants 3, the Yankees nothing. Ruffing is ready. Here's the pitch. Schumacher belts the curveball deep into center field. DiMaggio's backing up. He's under it, waiting, and he has it for the first out. Schumacher hit a high fly deep into center field. DiMaggio moved back to his right toward left center, backed up a few feet, and caught the ball for the first out. One gone. Here's the leadoff man, Joe Moore. Joe slaps a two-bagger down the third baseline. Starts the ball game today, and later scored on Dick Bartell's two-bagger. Ruffing is ready. Here's the pitch. Slow ball. He hits a high pop fly. Back at third base. Third baseman Rolf is backing up. He's in foul territory, and he has the ball for the second out. He caught the ball about 35 feet back of third base down the line and about 2 feet outside the line. Rolf caught that ball in foul territory. It was a high pop fly off the bat of Joe Moore. Here's Bartell. He doubled the first time up. Right-handed batter, here's the first pitch. Fastball right in around his waist, a call strike. Ruffing through in that sidearm fastball of his. Bartell watches it go by. Dick has made six hits in the series. He's out of the batter's box. Ruffing has started his motion and then stopped. Now he's ready again. Here's the next pitch. Curveball. He hits it down the third baseline. Foul just outside the bag. It looked like a hit there. It went just outside the bag. Foul. A low bounding ball. Left fielder Powell comes over the line, throws the ball back into the discard. Now it's two strikes on Bartell. No balls called. Two outs. Nobody on the bases. First half of the second inning. The Giants three and the Yankees nothing. Here's the windup of the pitch. Bartell struck out. Fastball shoulder high. Bartell is out on strike. Retiring the side.
The New York Giants went down the order in their half of the second inning. Schumacher flying out to DiMaggio. Ball foul out to Rolf. And Bartell struck out. Going into the Yankees after the second inning. And score remains the Giants 3 and the Yankees nothing.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the fifth game of the World Series. Being played at the Yankee Stadium in New York City. We'll pause briefly now for station identification. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System.
This is WGN Tribune Square, Chicago.
Well, the New York Giants are on the field now. Ripple is walking into right center field, getting set for the first hitter, who's Lou Gehrig. They play this lad deep, and what a wonderful ball player he is. Here's Lou Gehrig up to face Schumacher. Giants are ready on the infield and the outfield. Nobody on and nobody out. We're starting the last half of the second. Giants 3, Yankees nothing. Wind up and here's the pitch to Gehrig. Fastball, he hits the ground ball to Perry. He's right. He can't get it. It's a hit in the right field. It's right through the right fielder. Well, Ripple has it. And he's getting around to third base. And he's safe at third. It'll be, I believe, a hit in the middle. He drove a ground ball to Perry Strike into right field for a safe hit. It's a hit and an error, a single and an error for Mellock, letting the ball go through his legs all the way to the wall in right field, and Gehrig is on third base. Next man to come up is the catcher, Bill Dickey. Man on third and nobody out. That was a well-hit ball between Perry and Whitehead. Now Gehrig's on third. Schumacher's ready to pitch to Bill Dickey. First pitch is very wide, shoulder high, a ball, ball one. All the way back to the wall where it's marked 344 feet. Ripple was running over fast and right center, backing out up. And Ripple received the ball, got it back in fast, Ripple to Whitehead. But Gehrig was over at third base, so Whitehead didn't throw it. The outfield playing this fellow plenty deep. Here's the next pitch from Schumacher. Over the plate, he hits the bounding ball down the first base line. Schumacher picks it up. Back over the first, he's out. Gehrig's flying to the plate. He is out of the plate. Gehrig is out of the plate. Gehrig, the man, too slow. The batter hit a slow-rolling ball down the first base line, 5 feet inside the line. The pitcher picked the ball up halfway between the plate and first. Picked the ball up and threw it to first base, retiring the batter, Dickey. With the throw, Gehrig went long lead, beat it for the plate, and is out on a very close play, carried a man to so. It was a very exciting play, and very close to the plate. Hope you understand it clearly now. It was a batted ball down the first base line, a slow roller, pitcher threw the batter off, and then Gehrig at third base, slide for the plate, was out on a very close, fast play, carried a man to so. Here's Selkirk. The first pitch is low and inside for a ball. The Yankees took a chance that time. And they almost got away with it.
Now there's nobody on the bases and two gone. Selkirk is up. He's made four hits in the series. Schumacher has the glove off now. He rubs the ball around in his hand. It's already out there. The Giants talk it up. He's hitting all the way up here. He's ready to wind up. Here's the next pitch to Selkirk. It's a long drive. Way back into right field. It's got a home run. It's back. It's a home run. Over the right field. Selkirk just hit a long, tremendous home run. Way back into the stands. Right field. About 355 feet from the plate. And here he comes around third base. He's dropping down the third base line. And he's getting a swell hand for a wonderful home run. Gee, that was a beautiful hit. It's way into the air and way back into right field. And there was no doubt about what it was going to be just as soon as the ball left his bat. Score now is 3-1. Next man to come up is Powell. First pitch to Powell is a cold strike, right around his knees. He's getting ready out there again. Two out and nobody out. Here's the next pitch to Powell. Curveball in a little bit close above the knees. The ball and the count is 1-1. That was Selkirk's fifth hit of the series and his second home run. Boy, that was a beauty. Here's the windup for the next pitch. Fastball, he hits a short fly ball in the center field. Hitler's coming in fast, he's under it, and he has the ball on the run. Truly tied the side. That is the end of the second inning. The score, the Giants lead, and the Yankees won. All right, Tony.
Now is the time to consider a better car that will stand the cold winter weather. The Ford dealer's nationwide clearance sale of used cars is in full swing, featuring 150,000 used car and truck bargains. Your Ford dealer has late models of many different makes. In the Yank half of the second inning, Gehrig, the first man up, smacked the ball out to right field where it got away from Mallard. In the meantime, Gehrig moved on down to third. Dickey was out, Schumacher to Terry, and Gehrig was out at the plate, Terry to Mancuso. Selkirk knocked one into the right field bleachers, a drive of about 355 feet for a home run. With two down, Powell came up and he flied out to center field, a ripple, retiring the side. We're going into the Giant half of the third inning, and score stands the Giants 3 and the Yankees 1.
Now the Yankees are on the field. Here's the first man to bat for the Giants, Bill Terry. Terry struck out the first time. Here's the pitch. Over the plate, he hits the bounding ball over the shortstop left. Corsetti has it. A bounce over the first base. He's out. Corsetti to Gary. Terry hit a low bounding ball between the shortstop and the bag. Corsetti moves to his left. Over towards second base. Came up with the ball on the short hop and threw him out. Corsetti to Gary. Good luck. Out up. He was out. There's the first time. First pitch, he hits a high foul over near the railing. Behind third base. Third base is coming over fast with the Yankee dugout, but can't get through it. Hit on the roof of the dugout. High pop foul alongside third base over near the railing. Hit on the roof of the Yankee dugout. Ross couldn't get through it, and it's a foul strike on Hawk. One out. Nobody on the bases in the first half of the third. Pitchers are Ruffing, a right-hander, and Schumacher, a right-hander. Ruffing's getting his time. Stands on the rubber. He's all ready. Now to wind up in the pitch. Slow ball. Out hits the long fly ball in the left center. The Nigel's moving over. Powell is moving over. Powell caught it in left center field. The long fly ball off the bottom. Not out for the second out.
Here's Ripple. Drove a hit in the left field the first time up and scored a run. That was Jim's fourth hit of the series. Batting now is two out and nobody on the bases, facing Ruffing. Here's the pitch. First pitch is right down the middle, a fastball around his knees for a called strike. Two out and nobody on for the Giants in the first half of the third. They're ahead, 3-1. Here's the pitch. He swung it a low one that time with lots of speed on it and missed it. And it's two strikes now on Jim Ripple, the Giants center fielder. Mazzari, the second baseman, talking to umpire Major Kirk out there at second. He looks back at the scoreboard, turns around again to face the hitter. Ripple is out of the box. He's behind the batter's box right now, wiping his hands on his uniform. Pulls his cap on. He's stepping in right now to the right side of coach. He's a left-handed hitter. There's two strikes on him and no balls called. Ruffing is ready. Here's the windup and the pitch. Slow ball. Strike. He struck him out. A slow ball right over the outside corner, knee high. Ripple is out on strike. That's the end of the first half of the third.
The Giants went down in order in their half of third inning. Terry was out for Scotty DeGarry. Mellott fly out the foul and left center. And Ripple struck out. We're going into the last half of the third inning. Score stands the Giants 3, the Yanks 1. The Giants scoring 3 runs in their half of the first inning. The Yanks scoring 1 in the second. Okay, and back to Bob Elson.
Thank you, Tony. Well, the last half of the third inning is going to get underway now. The first man to come up is the second baseman of the Yankees, Tony Lazzeri. Lazzeri's had just one hit in the series, and what a hit it was. It made some baseball history because it's just the second time that that particular feat has been accomplished, and that is in the World Series, a home run with the bases loaded. Tony Lazzeri. Now the Giants play it around the infield for the last time. Third baseman Jackson is the last man to handle the ball. Goes to the Schumacher. And here's Lazzeri up to start the last half of the third. The score, the Giants 3, the Yankees 1. Now Schumacher's getting a sign. Here's the windup on the first pitch to Tony. It's a fastball low inside a ball. Schumacher takes a couple of kicks to the pitching mound with his right foot. Puts his cap down firmly on his head. Has his glove off. Now he's ready. Here's a windup in the pitch to Lazzeri. A fastball, and he dunks it off here to the right into the screen. And the count is ball one and strike one on Tony. The Yankees are at bat in the last half of the third with Lazzeri up. Second baseman of each team has made one hit of the series. Here's the pitch. Going outside, a ball. Both Lazzeri and Whitehead have come up with some sparkling plays in the series game, but each one of them has made just a single hit. Lazzeri's was a homer, Whitehead's was a single, and came today and drove in a run. Here's the pitch. Going outside, another ball makes it 3-1 for Lazzeri. The ball got away from the catcher. Got his glove in the way and sold it up, and he went over to his right to pick up the ball and throw it back to Schumacher. Schumacher looks down at Duff getting his sign. There's Mancuso crouching here below us. There's the pitch. Fastball right over the outside corner, knee high. Schumacher cuts the corner with a fastball. Count is ball 3 and strike 2. Ready out there again. Stands on the pitching rubber. There's the windup. Here's the next pitch. He missed the corner that time with a fastball, and he gets the walk. Schumacher slides the same pitch. A fastball, low outside, but he missed the corner, and it's 4-4. It brings up the pitcher, Red Ruffing. Now there's a man on first. Red Ruffing coming up. Nobody out in the last half of the third. The Giants move in just a little bit in the infield. The outfielders stay right where they are. This fella can hit him on the nose, too. Here's the pitch. In close at the knee, a ball. The first pitch to Ruffing. Ball one. Schumacher goes back. Picks up the rosin bag this time. Brushes it along the front of his pants. Now he's ready. And on first base and nobody out. Here's the pitch to Ruffing. In close to Tony, another ball. Ball two. Mancuso doesn't like that ball. He throws it out of the game now. The umpire, umpire Thurman, gives him a new one. Second baseman Whitehead comes in to talk to the pitcher. Now he's walking back to his position. Terry is on the bag. Bartell is playing in his natural shortstop position. Moves in a little bit. Jackson is playing about 7 or 8 feet inside the line. Here's the pitch. Ball three, outside knee high. The third ball now for Ruffing. We have the top of the batting order coming up next. Frank Corsetti. Schumacher is looking back for center field. Now he walks farther back and picks up the rosin bag, rides his hand. Down the pitching rubber now. Batter will undoubtedly take a couple here. Wait out the string. Here's the pitch. Ball rolling inside. He walks in. Hal Schumacher has started off the last half of the third inning. Developed a sudden wild streak.
Hal seems to be getting sort of in the mood he was in the first game that he pitched in the series when he was having a lot of trouble with his control. Well, now the picture is the Yankees have a man on second and a man on first. There's nobody out. The Giants are leading 3-1. And the next man to come up is the shortstop, the leadoff man, Frank Corsetti. Corsetti was out on strikes the first time up. Whitehead is still talking to Schumacher. Now he's going back. Terry is back over at first base. And we have two men on for the Yankees with nobody out in their half of the third. In other words, the tying runs are on the bases. Now Corsetti's up. Schumacher's all set. Here's the pitch. Bowing outside. Another ball. Ball one. The Giants are warming up a pitcher in right field. Can't see who it is. Back in the bullpen. He's underneath the stand. Schumacher again. Turns around. Takes his glove off. He's having trouble with his control this inning. He's walked the first two men. The tail end of the batting order. Which is bad. Lazzari and the pitcher. Al is getting his sign out there again. He's all ready. There's a bunt. Pitcher. It was a bunt. It looked like the ball had hit foul first. It did. Corsetti bunted. The ball hit foul. The ball was wrapped so sharply that it hit to the left of the plate. Foul. Hit Corsetti in the leg and then rolled out between the pitcher and the third base line. It all happened so fast that the spectators and everybody had the opinion that it was a fair ball. The umpire says no, it hit the batter. And it's very obvious now because Corsetti is limping around down here. Almost it caught him in the knee or in the shin someplace, and it evidently hurt. Frankie's limping around, and the runners are sent back to first and second. It was a break there for the Giants because Schumacher had fumbled the ball a couple of times before picking it up, and if it had been a fair ball, the bases would have been loaded. Now there's a count of ball, one, and strike. When it was a foul, two men on the bases now, and a count of one and one on the hitter, nobody out, in the last half of the third. Here's the next pitch to Corsetti. It's a bunt down the third baseline. It's fouled again. Schumacher moves over fast and steals the ball between the plate and third base, halfway down. But it's fouled, and the count now is ball one and strike two on Corsetti. Now we still have the same picture here, two men on, with a count of ball one and strike two on Corsetti. Mike still attempt to sacrifice those tying runs around the second and third, but if he should bunt it now and bunt it foul, he's automatically out and the runners cannot advance. Sometimes they do it because the infield now is backing up. They're going back into normal position now. Jackson and the third baseman and Perry, the first baseman, are backing up because it's very seldom that they would try that in a spot like this. But you never can tell. Schumacher's ready. Here's the pitch. The ball gets away from the catcher. The runners are advancing. Push runners on second and third. The ball got away from the catcher. It rolled over about 30 feet to the left of the plate. Wild pitch puts the man on second and the man on third. And a count of ball, two and strike two on the batter. Wild pitch, says the official score. Perry is over talking to Schumacher now. Well, the Yankees don't have to worry about a sacrifice because that wild pitch did the trick for them. Puts Lazzari on third and Ruffing on second. The Giants are leading 3-1. The game is in the last half of the third. Ball two, strike two for Corsetti. Schumacher's ready. Here's the pitch. It's a bounding ball to the shortstop, Bartell. Up with it, over to first base, a bad throw. Base at first, and a run scores. Bartell gets an error on a very bad throw to Perry. Lazzari scores from third. It's an error for Bartell on a very bad throw to Perry. Leaves Ruffing on second base. Corsetti on first base. A run is in, and the score now is 3-2 in favor of the Giants.
Bartell came up with the ball in plenty of time to make a play. Made a very fast throw. He threw the ball into the dirt about 10 feet in front of Terry. Terry threw his body in front of the ball. Stopped it all right, but couldn't hang on to the ball. And it's an error for Bartell. Now we have a man on first and a man on second. Here's Rothbuck. Tying run on second base for the Yankees and nobody out here in the last half of the third. Giants are expecting an attempted sacrifice. Here's the pitch. He bumps one right out in front of the plate. Schumacher picks it up, gets it over the first. He is safe. He beat it out for a hit, and the bases are loaded. Rolf played down a roller between the pitcher's mound and the plate. A bunted ball rolling out toward the pitcher. Schumacher hurried in, grabbed the ball, and threw it over the first base. But Rolf, a very fast man, beat it out for a hit, and the bases are loaded with nobody out. Three men on now. Next man to come up is DiMaggio. Three men on the bases. There's Joe DiMaggio up. Bounced off to Jackson the first time up. He'll be followed by Gehrig and then Dickey. Now the Giants have moved in close. Bases are loaded. Nobody out. Ruffing on third, Cuddy on second, Rolf on first. First pitch, he hits a high foul. Back near the screen, it's going into the screen. Right here below us. DiMaggio hit a high foul. It came back to the screen and dropped into the screen as Mancuso hustled back, hoping that the ball would be into a spot where he could get his punches on it, but he couldn't. And it's a foul strike on Joe DiMaggio. DiMaggio has five hits in the series. Yesterday, Joe rolled out twice, right out once, and on the last appearance, into a fast double play. Hal Schumacher is very much on the spot here in the Yankee Stadium in this last half of the third inning. The Giants still have a one-run lead, but it looks bad. 3-2 in their favor, but the Yankees have the bases loaded. Here's the next pitch to DiMaggio. He swung and fouled, tipped another one, and the count is two strikes on Joe. Yes, DiMaggio, Gehrig, and Dickey, the base in order. There's nobody out in the base is loaded. If he walks around out there, Terry said something to him. The fifth game of the World Series. Nothing opposing Hal Schumacher. No DiMaggio's up at the plate, but the base is loaded. Schumacher gets all set. The pitch is inside, close to his head. Joe ducks out of the way. Now it's ball one, strike two. Bases loaded. Nobody out. One run in. The Giants three. The Yankees two. The Yankee half of the third. The last half. They have three men on with nobody out. Schumacher's getting all set. Here's the next pitch. He struck out. DiMaggio swung at a fifth pitch. Low and outside and struck out. DiMaggio is out on strike.
Next man to come up is Gary. Joe DiMaggio was out on strike. Now Bill Terry is talking to the pitcher again. Here's Lou Gehrig up. Lou rifled a hit into right field the first time up, on which Melott made an error. And Lou went all the way around to third. Batting now with the bases loaded. What a spot this is. DiMaggio has to face it. He's going right to work on this fellow now. Here's the windup on the first pitch. Gehrig swung and missed. A curveball right around his knee. Gehrig went all the way around that time, trying to get that ball a ride. Catcher wants to talk to the pitcher now. Schumacher walks in rather gingerly, as though he didn't have a care in the world. Bases are loaded for the Yankees with one gone. He struck DiMaggio out. They've scored a run this inning. The umpire wants to look the ball over now. See that Hal isn't putting any hocus pocus on it. He says it's okay, and he throws the ball back to the pitcher. Lou Gehrig is up with the bases loaded here in the fifth game of the World Series in this mammoth Yankee Stadium in New York City. One gone. Schumacher gets ready again. Here's the next pitch. There's a slow roller foul down the first baseline. Two strikes on Gehrig. Two strikes on Lou Gehrig. Catcher Mancuso again walks out toward the pitcher. Al Schumacher walks in, says something, then he goes back to the mound. Ruffing on third, Corsetti on second, Rolf on first. Two strikes on Gehrig, one gone, and the Giants have a one-run lead. Here's the pitch. Strike three, struck him out. Schumacher struck out Gehrig, a big hook right around his knees, and Gehrig is out on strike. Two balls. Boy, what a break there was on that one. That had a hook on it like a letter V. Now there's two gone. The bases are still loaded. Here's Hickey up. Bases loaded. Still Hickey up at the plate. He rolled out to the pitcher the first time up. Al Schumacher takes his time out there, getting all set. Here's the pitch to Bill. Low and outside, a ball. Ball one. Next man to come up is Selkirk. Schumacher takes his time. He's ready out there now. Here's the pitch. It's a high fly into right field. Mellon is under it. He should get it. He's moving in. He's standing under it. He has it. He's firing it down. Three men are left on the bases, and Hal Schumacher came through with a marvelous pitching performance there, and he's getting a wonderful hand here at the Yankee Stadium from friend and foe alike. American League and National League fans giving Schumacher a swell hand. All right, Tony.
In the Giant half, or rather the Yankee half of that third inning, with Barry the first mouth walks, Ruffing walks, then Corsetti came up to the plate, the wild pitch on the part of Schumacher, and both runners at bat. With Barry moving down to third, Ruffing to second. And then Corsetti wrapped the ball down the short. Bartell shoved it up, take it over to Bill Terry. It was a very, very fast toss, and the Terry scored. Bartell was charged with an error. Rolf followed. He bunted and beat out the toss. Schumacher to Terry, filling up the base. Then up came DiMaggio. He struck out. Gehrig struck out. And Dickey flied out to Mellon in right field, retiring the side. We're going into the Giant half of the fourth inning, and the score stands the Giants 3 and the Yankees 2.
Now the Yankees are on the field. DiMaggio in center field. Selkirk in right field. Powell in left field. Gehrig first. Missouri second. Corsetti short. Rolf third. Dickey is catching, and Ruffing is the pitcher. Right-handers today. Ruffing and Schumacher. Al showed plenty of heart that inning. Bases loaded, nobody out. Got onto that spot without anybody scoring after that one run had been in. So now we find the picture as we start the first half of the fourth inning. The New York Giants have three runs. The New York Yankees have two. Here's the first man to bat, Dutch Mancuso. Dutch had a single to right the first time up. This is getting ready out there. Now the windup in the pitch. He swung at a fastball right around his waist and almost fell down. One strike on Gus. Fourth inning. A wonderful game out here. Ruffing juggles the ball in his level 2 seconds. Gets ready. Here's the pitch. He threw his fast slipped out of his hands. It's a foul. Rolled off to the left. The bat is out behind the pitcher. Ross goes over and picks it up. Now he's walking toward Mancuso. He's out next to the pitcher. So he rolls the bat to him. Gus picks it up, and he's walking right down the line now from the pitcher toward the plate. Rolf is backing up, going back to third. Mancuso is the first man up in the fourth. The Giants have a one-run lead. He's getting his sign out there now. He's all ready. Here's the pitch. There's a hard hit ball, a line drive down the left field line. Powell comes over, plays the ball off the fence. Gus is on his way to second base, and he goes in, standing up, a two-bagger for Mancuso. A line drive, right over the third baseman's head. Roll down the line, off the front of the stands down there in left field. Powell plays the ball hard,
leads up this bat if he could.
But it's an easy two-bagger for Mancuso, and it brings up Whitehead. Azari is in talking to Ruffing. Here's Whitehead up. He had a hit the first time up today. First pitch is low and inside to Burgess. Ball one. Ralph, Corsetti, Lazzari, and Gary talk it up out there in the infield. And on second base, here's the next pitch. It's a curveball in across his knees for a called strike. Lots of dope on that one. The count is ball one and strike one. Whitehead backs out of the batter's box. He's drying his hands down. Now he's up in there again. The man on second, Whitehead up. He's getting ready out there again. Here's the next one. He hits one right back of the pitcher. There they throw the ball to second base, and Mancuso is called off at second base. Nothing to Corsetti. Whitehead hit a ground ball right at the pitcher, Ruffing, who picks it up, turned and fired the ball back to Corsetti, and Mancuso is out, trying to get back to second base, Ruffing to Corsetti. The batter, naturally, is safe at first. Here's the third baseman, Jackson. He flied out to left center field the first time up. Giants have a man on first with Jackson up. Now Ruffing is ready. First pitch he swung at and missed. Right around his knees. One strike on Jackson. Whitehead on first with one out. Ruffing is getting his sign again. Here's the next pitch. Jackson hits a high foul. Right up on top of the roof over behind first base. And the count is two strikes on Travis. Jackson has made three hits in the series. Ruffing has his glove off out there. He's rubbing the ball around in his hand. Now he's all set. Here's the next pitch. Jackson took one. A hook blown outside for the ball. Count is one and two. Whitehead on first. One gone. First half of the fourth inning. The Giants leading in a close ball game, 3-2. The pitchers are Ruffing and Schumacher, right-handers. Pitcher's getting a sign out there again. Here's the next pitch. Jackson hits a pop-up in the infield. The shortstop, Corsetti, is right near the bag. He has the ball for the second out. Travis Jackson pops out to Corsetti. Corsetti caught the ball about 5 feet to the shortstop side of second. Here's the pitcher, Schumacher. Al gets a nice hand to the ball, and he deserves it for that wonderful pitching performance last inning. Ruffing is taking his time out there getting ready now to pitch to Schumacher. He sent a long fly ball to DiMaggio the first time up. He has the reputation of being a good hitting pitcher. Here's the pitch. He swung hard that time at a fastball around his knees, and it's one strike on Schumacher. The man on first, two gone here in the first half of the fourth inning. Red Ruffing opposing. There's a throw to first base, but the runner is back in easily. Gary tosses the ball back to the pitcher. Getting all set again. Here's the next pitch. Fastball over the outside corner, knee high, a called strike. It's two strikes now on Schumacher. Ruffing walks around out there, thumps the ball in his glove a couple of times. Arms up in front of him, drops him down. He's ready. Here's the pitch. Schumacher struck out, a fastball right around his waist. One man left on the bases, and it retires the side. Here's Tony Wakeman.
Mancuso saw the first man up for the New York Giants in a line drive down the third baseline, which was good for a double. Whitehead followed. He wrapped one down to the mound, up and shoved up the ball, tossed into Corsetti. Mancuso was out trying to get back to second. Jackson popped out to Corsetti, and Schumacher struck out. We're going into the last half of the fourth inning. Score stands the Giants 3, the Yanks 2. The Giants scoring three runs in the first, the Yanks scoring one in the second, and one in the third. Now back to Bob Elf.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the fifth game of the World Series being played at the Yankee Stadium in New York City. We'll pause briefly now for station identification. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System.
This is WGN Tribune Square, Chicago.
Now the first man to bat for the Yankees is Selkirk. Hit a home run the first time up, and it was a beauty. Real drive back into the seats in right field. Here's Selkirk, starting the last half of the fourth inning facing Schumacher. Now getting ready out there now. Here's the pitch. First pitch is blown outside. A ball to Selkirk. Ball one. Nobody on and nobody out in the last half of the fourth. The Giants three and the Yankees two. He's winding up again. Here's the next pitch. Hits the ball. It's outside the knee. Makes it ball two. Schumacher has issued two passes today. They both came in the third inning. He passed Luzzeri and then he passed the pitcher. Ball two is the count. Here's the next pitch. Right around his knees, a call strike. Makes a call two and strike one for Selkirk. Tall, slender fellow who has lots of power. Room around that outfield, too. Giants keep up the chatter out there in the infield. Lots of pepper on both sides. Schumacher's winding up. Here comes the next pitch. Too low. Threw that sinker in that time. The ball with that quick stop on it. But it broke in too low. And the count now is ball three and strike one for Selkirk. Schumacher gets ready again. Next pitch is ball four. He walked him. Here's Powell up. Powell fired off the center field the first time up. Just as the pitcher delivered the ball, just as the ball was about to leave his hand, Selkirk made a quick swing off to the right. Sort of a rattle him a little bit. May have helped. Anyway, two in a ball. Ball four. And on first base, and Powell is up. Here's the pitch. Low and outside. A ball. Ball one. And Chusto is going out to talk to Schumacher. Now they're out there talking it over between the rubber and the plate. Standing right together. Dust is coming back now, sort of, toward the plate. Our spot is exactly behind the home plate. First base to our right and third base to our left. And the grand spot will tell you exactly what happened. The giant infield has moved in just a little bit. Foul fight out the first time up. Now Schumacher is getting a sign again. The next pitch is a little bit too close. Waist high for the ball and the count is ball two. On first base for the Yankees in the last half of the fourth inning. They're trailing by one run. Schumacher getting his sign again. He's ready as a pitch. Hits the ball inside above his knees. It's ball three. Schumacher's having another one of those wild streaks. The Giants are warming up a pitcher in the bullpen in right field. Perry is over talking to Schumacher. Standing out there next to the pitcher's box, talking it over. Mancuso, Perry, and Schumacher. Next man to bat after Powell will be Luzzeri, and then the pitcher. The score, the Giants 3, the Yankees 2. The game is in the last half of the fourth. Ruffing and Schumacher. Now he's ready out there again. Next pitch is ball four inside at the knee. Puts two men on the bases again for the Yankees.
first and a man on second. Next man to come up is Lazzari. Whitehead, Terry move over from the right side of the infield to say something to the pitcher. Surge him and try to settle him down out there. Two men on now. Here's Lazzari up. He threw a base on balls the first time. Schumacher's ready to pitch to him. First pitch he bunts to Schumacher, gets it over to third base, it's out at third. A force out. An attempted sacrifice was turned into a force out. A bunt between the pitcher's box and the third baseline, about halfway down. Schumacher moved over fast, picked up the ball, and fired it to Jackson at third base. And Selkirk is out. Schumacher to Jackson. Leaves a man on first and a man on second and brings up the pitcher, Ruffing. The attempted sacrifice was turned into a force play. So now we have Ruffing up. He drew a base on balls the first time. Big fellow and a right-handed hitter. Schumacher's getting his signs. Here's the pitch. Right over the plate. He hits the bounding ball past the pitcher. Bartell is up with it. Over the second out. Back over the first. Out of the double play. He's a bounding ball. A high bounding ball over the pitcher's head. Right out to the shortstop. About 5 feet to the shortstop side of the bag. Dick Bartell caught it. Flipped it to Whitehead. Whitehead turned and fired it to Terry. And he got his man on the tail end of the double play. Just by a step to retire the side. And that's the end of the fourth inning. And here's Tony Wink.
Get the thrill of V8 performance. Drive a Ford V8. It's the only car under $1,600 with a V-type 8-cylinder engine. Your nearest Ford dealer has one he'll be glad to let you drive. And now in the Yank half of the fourth inning, the first two men walk, Selkirk and Powell. Lazzari bunted to Schumacher, shoveled up the ball, tossed it into third, and Selkirk was out at third. Ruffing then hit into a double play, retiring the side. We go into the Giant half now, the fifth inning, and the score stands the Giants 3 and the Yankees 2.
Well, the fifth inning of a wonderful ball game here in this fifth game of the World Series is coming up. Red Ruffing and Hal Schumacher pitching swell ball out here. Plenty of tight spots, long hits, exciting plays, all that you could ask of our great national pastime, good old baseball. And here's Joe Moore up. He had a double the first time. The second time, he popped out the wall. That's handed it. Here's a pitch, a slow ball. He hits it on the ground. Gehrig is up with it, running to the bag. Sickler's coming over to take the ball. He's out. Gehrig to Ruffing. Ball was hit well behind the bag. Gehrig picks it up on the hop. Threw it to the pitcher, Ruffing, who came over. Gehrig gets the assist, and the pitcher gets the put out. It was a pretty fast play with more of a fast man getting down there in a hurry. So there's one gone, and here's Bartell. An up twice, a double and a strikeout. Bartell up. He's made 6 hits in the series. Scores the Giants 3, the Yankees 2 in the fifth inning. Now Ruffing is ready. First pitch is a strike right over the outside corner, knee high. There's an airplane zooming overhead. Bartell is watching the pitcher. Here's the windup in the next pitch. He starts one way down the left field line, but it's a foul ball. Bartell hit one high up into the upper deck, way down the left field line, but it was foul. And it's 2 strikes now. Big steps out of the batter's box and gets up in there again. One out, nobody on for the Giants in the first half of the fifth. They're ahead. 3-2. Ruffing smooths the ball around his hand. Gets all ready again. Here's the next pitch. Bartell takes one inside, but over shoulder. Too close. And the count is 4-1, strike 2. Yankees popping up out there. Lost at third. Corsetti at short. Lazzari at second. Gary at first. Selkirk in right. DiMaggio in center. And Powell in left. There's the windup again on the next pitch. Fastball. Strike 3. Right across his knees. And he's out on strike. Bartell is called out on strike. Here's Terry. Terry struck out the first time. And the second time he was easy out on roller to the shortstop. Terry has made 5 hits in the series. Here's Bill Terry up.
Ruffing is ready. Here's the first pitch. Terry takes one high and wide for the ball. Ball one. Ruffing kicked the pitching lever a couple of times with his right foot. Now he's leans over, going to pick up a cover or something. Ball set out there again. Now there's the start of his motion. Here's the next pitch to Terry. Over the plate, and he hits a high foul between the plate and third base. Outside the line, Ralph is over. Halfway down and has the ball. Easy out. Terry popped out to Ralph. A high foul. About 25 feet outside the line and about halfway between the plate and third. An easy out to Ralph. And it retires the side.
The Giants went down in order in their half of the fifth. Moore was out. Gary Ruffing had covered first. Bartell struck out. And Terry fouled out to Ralph down the third base line. We're going into the last half of the fifth inning, and the score stands the Giants 3 and the Yankees 2. Now the Giants are on the field. The first man to bat for the Yankees. Coming out now, Corsetti. You remember the side was retired for the Yankees in the last half of the fourth inning when the pitcher Red Ruffing hit into a fast double play, short to second to first. Hal Schumacher's out there on the mound. Bartell is standing right near the bag, talking to Whitehead, who has covered the bag. And he was 1 foot on one side of the bag and one on the other, waiting for the catcher's throw. Jackson is talking to the pitcher. Terry is walking around over there to our right. The outfielders are all set. Ripple is walking around in center field. Now he's turning around. Well, the Giants are leading 3-2 in the last half of the fifth inning. Hal Schumacher held the Yankees to 3 hits. Worked his way out of a couple of tough spots. Here's Corsetti up. He struck out the first time, and the second time he was safe on an error. Now the wind up in the first pitch to Frankie. First pitch. Here it is. Strike right around his knee. Ball. Nobody on. Nobody out. Last half of the fifth inning, Giants 3, Yankees 2. Winding up, here's the next pitch. Curve ball, he fouled it off there to the left. Bounced up and hit him in the leg and rolled out again in front of the plate. Mancuso gets the ball and tosses it back to Schumacher. Nobody warming up for either team. A nice close pitcher's battle here. Close game. Gets the sign out there. He's all ready. Here's the next pitch to Corsetti. Strike three. Struck him out. A third ball over the outside corner, knee high. Corsetti is out on strike. He's putting up a beat down here. Complaining to the umpire about it. He's out on strike. Now the next man to come up is the third baseman, Red Ruffing. Here's Ruffing up at the plate. Schumacher's ready. Here's the pitch. He punts one. The pitcher, right. He sent him there. He comes in fast and got over first base, but couldn't come up with it. He punted between the pitcher and first base to Schumacher's left, rather. Schumacher made a stab at the ball, but couldn't get it. Whitehead tore in fast. He came up with the ball, fired at the first base, but missed his man. Ralph is really fast and beat it out for a hit. It was a beautiful punt between the bag at first base and the pitcher's box. Schumacher moved hurriedly to his left, made a stab at the ball and fell down but couldn't get it. As he reached for it, Whitehead moved in fast, came up at the ball and made a fast play, but he couldn't head Ralph off, and Ralph beats it out for a hit. It was a nice play, a very nice punt by Ralph. That's Red's second hit, and it's the fourth hit off of Schumacher. Now the next man to come up is DiMaggio. He struck out last time with the bases loaded. Hit for Ross. Here's Joe DiMaggio. Bounced out to Jackson the first time. The second time he struck out. And on first base. He's getting ready. Here's the first one. Low and inside, a ball to Joe. Ball one. The Yankees haven't tried any thievery on Mancuso as far as running the bases. The Giants have tried 20. The tying run is on first base for the Yankees. The Giants are leading 3-2 in the last half of the fifth. The Yankees have a man on first with one gone.
Corsetti struck out.
Schumacher steady out there now. Here comes the next pitch to DiMaggio. Inside, a fastball, and it's too close. Ball two. 2-0 now for Joe. Schumacher turns around, looks around the infield and the outfield. Turning around again now, facing the batter. Ruff has a short lead off of first. He's very fast. He's very dangerous. Out there on the bases. Run like a jackrabbit. Pitcher getting all set. Here it is. DiMaggio takes a strike right across his knees. Makes it 4-2 and strike one. Ruff goes back to first. Keeps on keeping an eye on him. Pitcher careful not to let the base runner get any lead on him. And he jumps on his delivery. Schumacher watches the man over his left shoulder, draws his arms up. Runner is lifting off. Here's the pitch. Hits the ball. It's long inside, and it's 4-3 and strike one for DiMaggio. Yankee center fielder, starting in the last half of the fifth inning with the Yankees trailing by one run. Score is 3-2 in favor of the Giants. Ruff came through with his second hit, a bunt after one out. Came first base in the pitcher's box, and he beat it out. Of course, the home trick in a bump like that is to get it past the pitcher. Once you do, you've got a whale of a chance of beating it out, and he did. Pitch to DiMaggio is right over the plate, knee high for a called strike. Schumacher put plenty on that one and fired it right in there, and it's a count of 3-2 on Joe DiMaggio. Hal Schumacher getting his time now. DiMaggio batting with a tying run on first base and one gone. Schumacher turns around, looks back around the infield and outfield. Well, he's worked his way out of a number of tough spots today. Been in serious trouble twice. Schumacher's getting a sign again. It's a 3-2 count on DiMaggio. Left to runner. There he goes. Strike three. He's out there to say the second base. Fourth seed out. A double play. DiMaggio struck out and left without going to second base. Manchu fell to Bartell and took the throw. DiMaggio struck out on a fastball at the outside corner of the shoulder. Mancuso fired the ball to second base and Ruff was out attempting to strike second base on a perfect throw. Mancuso to Bartell. That's the end of the fifth inning. The Giants 3 and the Yankees 2. All right, Tony.
Today you drive your present car decreases in value. Take advantage of a Ford dealer's nationwide used car clearance sale now in progress to get a better used car. Your Ford dealer has his share of the 150,000 bargains being featured. Look in your local newspaper for special bargains in R&G used cars. They are renewed and guaranteed. And in the ninth half, the fifth inning, Corsetti, the first man up, struck out. Ruff beat out of toss, Whitehead to play. And DiMaggio struck out. Mancuso played the ball down to second and got Ruff at second, retiring the side. We're going in now to the Giant half, the sixth inning. And the score remains the Giants 3, the Yanks 2. The Yanks scoring one in the second and one in the third. The Giants scoring 3 runs in the first. Well, the first half of the sixth inning of a wonderful game is going to get underway now. Everyone sort of has the feeling that Hal Schumacher is sitting on a keg of dynamite out there. But he's been working his way out of spot after spot. Here's Mel out up. Red Ruffing is ready. Here's the first pitch to little Mel. There's a hit to the shortstop. A hard liner. He went up into the air to try to pull it down, but couldn't get it. Here's the ball coming in from Powell, and Ott is on first. He nailed a line drive right over Corsetti's head. Corsetti went into the air with his gloved hand that time, but couldn't head it off, and it's a hit. Here's Whipple up. That was Mellott's fifth hit of the series. Here's Jim Whipple coming up now. We have Mancuso and Whitehead coming up in order. Ott leads off with a hard hit to left center. Powell took the ball on the second box. The pitch to Ripple. Outside, waist high, a ball. Yet his bat shortened. Though he might attempt to bunt it, and Ruff was moving in fast. Man on first base for the Giants. They're batting in the first half of the sixth inning. They're leading in this ball game, 3-2. Nip and tuck affair here, as everybody on edge.
Next pitch is low and inside. Whipple was going to bunt it, all right. But the ball broke sharply, and the batter, to get away from the impression that he was taking a poke at the ball, fell down. Ball was breaking so sharply in low and close, he started to go down for it, and then held his bat and fell down. Ball two now for Ripple. The pitch outside, waist high, ball three. Third baseman Rolf moving in fast, ball three. 3-0 now for Ripple. The Giants center fielder was out on first base in the sixth inning, and nobody out. Pitch is ready again. Here's the next pitch. Ball four. He walked it. Giants had runners on second and first now. They're not going down to second. Just stepped down the bag down there. Ripple's already standing on the bag at first. Here's Mancuso coming up. He's been up twice and he has two hits, a single and a double. And on first and a man on second, the Giants are leading 3-2. Next man to come up will be Whitehead and then Jackson. Yankees are third baseman is playing in, expecting a bunt. Here's the pitch. High inside a ball, ball one. The Yankees are warming up a pitcher now in the bullpen in left field. Third baseman Rolf is playing in, expecting Mancuso to lay it down. Man on first and a man on second. Ruffing is getting ready to pitch again. Here it is. It's a bunt. The pitch is over the first base, and he's out. It was a bunt between the pitcher's box and the third baseline, or just over a few feet. Ruffing had to move just about 6 or 7 feet to his right to come up with the ball. It was a perfect sacrifice, and it advanced the runners to second and third. Now the Giants have a man on second and a man on third, and the second baseman Burgess Whitehead is coming up. It was a bunt between the pitcher's box and the third baseline. Easy bunt for Ruffing to handle. Ball was rolling pretty fast, and he had an easy play at first base. It's a sacrifice for Mancuso. Whitehead's been up twice and has made one hit. Yankee infield has gone in. Here's the pitch. Third ball, way outside, waist high for a ball. The Giants are leading 3-2 in this fifth game of the World Series. The game is now in the first half of the sixth inning. Red Ruffing and Hal Schumacher have pitched all the way. Yankee infield playing in. Now Ruffing is winding up again. Here's the next pitch to Whitehead. Here's the bombing ball to the shortstop. He's on the ball. A run score. He had a bounding ball with the shortstop, Corsetti. It got away from him. Corsetti finally retrieved the ball, but it was too late to make a play anywhere. Otto scored, and the Giants are leading 4-2. They have runners on first and third, and Jackson is up. The ball was hit between the pitcher's box and third base, directly at the shortstop. He came in fast. It was a slow hopper. And he fumbled the ball. Put the man on first and a man on third. Here's Jackson up now. As they're going to call it. Here's Jackson up. The first pitch is a strike right around his knee. Haven't had any word yet from the relative, the official score. And on first and a man on third for the Giants with a run in. They're leading 4-2. The pitch hits a foul off there to the right into the grandstand. Two strikes on Jackson. Jackson's been up twice today. Tried out the first time, popped out the second time. Not get any word yet from the official score. I believe it'll be an error for Corsetti, but we don't want to do any guessing on that. Our only chance to get it is from the official score here below us.
It's an error for Corsetti.
Gord Mellon from third. Ripple advances to third. And the batter, Whitehead, is on first. Jackson is up with a count on middle. Ball one and two strikes. The Giants are leading 4-2. The next pitch. Strike three, struck him out again. Third ball right around his knee. Jackson's out. Man on first and a man on third with two gone now. Next man to come up is Hal Schumacher. Here he comes. Nice hand to the dot. The Yankees going to a short huddle out there. Here's Schumacher coming up with a teammate on first and a teammate on third. One run in, two gone. First half of the sixth inning. Giants ahead 4-2. Schumacher flied out, deep to center field the first time, the second time he struck out. Now he's facing Ruffing. There's a foul into the stands off here to the right, one strike. Giants are driving the first half of the sixth. He's taking his time out there again, getting ready. On that error of Corsetti's, the run would have scored anyway, I believe, even if he'd have picked it up cleanly. Pitch is low and inside, but he would have had the man at first, but because he fumbled the ball, there was no play anywhere. The run scored, and the batter had life at first. He said he was charged with an error. Even if he had picked the ball up cleanly, it was a slow roller, I think the runner would have scored because Ott was off just as soon as the ball was hit. Ruffing is ready. Next pitch. Schumacher swung hard that time, trying to give it a ride and missed it. Now it's ball one and strike two. Giants have a man on first and a man on third. They're leading in the sixth inning, 4-2, and this is the fifth game of the World Series. Red Ruffing opposing Hal Schumacher. The Giants pitcher is here at bat. Ruffing is getting his sign. He's ready out there. Here it is. Inside, high. Schumacher fell down in the batter's box to get out of the way of the pitch close to his head. Now it's ball two and strike two. Two and two now. Yankees talking up out there in the infield. Man on first, the man on third. Here's the next pitch to Schumacher. Strike three, struck him out. Curveball right around his knees. Schumacher swung hard and missed it. The tires aside, and two men are left on the bases. That's the end of the first half of the sixth inning of this, the fifth game of the World Series, being played at the Yankee Stadium in New York City. And I will pause briefly for station identification. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System.
This is WGN Tribune Square, Chicago. In the giant half of the sixth inning, the first man up spot smacked one down over short for a single. Ripple walk, out automatically moved to second. Mancuso punted and was out roughing to Gehrig. Both runners advanced. Whitehead hit to Corsetti. Fumbled the ball, and he was charged with an error, off scoring on the play. Jackson struck out. Schumacher struck out, retiring his side. We go into the last half of the sixth inning, and score stands the Giants 4 and the Yankees 2. The Giants scoring 3 in the first, 1 in the sixth. The Yanks 1 in the second, and 1 in the third.
Now the first man to bat for the Yankees is Lou Gehrig. Gehrig struck out last time with the bases loaded. Here's Gehrig up. Lou Gehrig out of the plate. First pitch, right around his knees, over the outside corner. All strike on Gehrig. Now Schumacher takes his time out there, getting ready. Outfield and infield is moved around. One pitch to right for Gehrig. Now Schumacher's getting all set again. The score is the Giants 4, the Yankees 2 in the last half of the sixth. It's a bounding ball between first and second. Whitehead has been leaped into the air over the first base. He's out. Gehrig hit a high bounding ball. Whitehead back at the edge of the glass, exactly between first and second. That's swept into the air. The ball took a very high bounce, and he threw him out. Whitehead to third. Next man to come up is Dickey. Schumacher takes the time out there, getting ready again. Nobody warming up for the Giants. The Yankees are warming up a pitcher. Pitch, low, ball, ball one. One out of nobody on. Last half of the sixth. Here's the next pitch to Bill. Perfect pitch. Right around his knees. A call strike. And the count is one and one.
Yankees have batted in the last half of the sixth inning. One gone, nobody on the bases. Gary just bounced out to Whitehead. Hal Schumacher's all set. There's the windup. Here's the next pitch. He struck it, a curveball right in around his knees, and he missed it. The count is 4-1 and strike two. There was a big hook on that one. Puts his cap down firmly on his head. The ball set out there again. I think he's been up twice today. Bounced out and flied out. Here's the next pitch. Strike two. Struck him out. He gave him that big hook again around his knees. And Dickey struck out. He's gone. Now the next man to come up is Selkirk. Selkirk has been up twice. He hit a home run and he walked. Schumacher's getting ready out there. Now the windup in the pitch. Too low with the ball. Ball one. Nobody on the bases and two gone in the last half of the sixth. Hal Schumacher and Red Ruffing have pitched all the way in this, the fifth game of the World Series.
The next pitch, there's a hit on the ground in the center field. Selkirk singles to center. Ripple juggles the ball momentarily, and the batter rounds first base, but pulls up as Ripple gets the ball back in a hurry. Selkirk gets his second hit of the game, a single to center, on the ground all the way. Kind of a hit ball. It just hugged the ground all the way out. There were no bounces at all. Here's Powell up. Powell has been up twice. He fired off the center field and he walked. Batting now with a teammate on first base. Two gone here in the last half of the sixth. The pitch. There's that curveball again and he swung hard and missed it. One strike. And on first. Right hand hitter up at the plate. Runner on first base is a fairly comfortable leadoff. Schumacher's all set. Here's the next pitch to Powell. Hits the roller down the third base line. Jackson comes in fast up with it. It's going to be close. He is. Jackson made a wild throw through the ball past Perry. Here's the runner coming in. Selkirk is carrying to the plate. Powell is going to third. And he's safe at third. Jackson made a very fast throw. Threw the ball over Perry's head, over against the railing. The ball rolled into right field. A run has scored, and the score is 4-3 now. And Powell gets all the way around to third. The slow roller down the third baseline. Jackson moves in fast, fires the ball over Terry's head over against the railing. The official scorer credits Powell with a hit, charges Jackson, of course, with an error. Powell gets a hit on it. He's all the way around on third. On Jackson's bad throw over Terry's head. Terry leaps into the air and tried to head the ball off. The ball hit the railing in front of the boxes. Rebounded into right field. Now there's two outs. Brian Hill is on third base for the Yankees. On Jackson's error. Giants are leading 4-3. Here's the Terry. He walks today and hit into a force play. Last half of the sixth inning, Schumacher's ready. Here's the pitch. There's the roller. Foul to the left of the plate. One strike. Giants play it around. Jackson to Bartell, to Whitehead, to Perry. Well, Jackson hadn't made the wild throw. The worst that could have happened would have been the runner advancing, because it looked like the runner would have beaten it out for a hit anyway. But Jackson's bad throw allowed the run to score. Threw the ball over Terry's head. Here's the next pitch to Lazzari. It's an inside pass. There's a throw to center. Powell is back safely. The ball almost got away from Jackson. It did get out of his hands and rolled over the third baseline. But not far enough to allow Powell to get in. The Giants are leading 4-3 in the last half of the sixth. The man on third base. Two gone. Flying run is on third for the Yankees now. Schumacher takes his time out there getting ready. The count is 4-1, strike one on Tony Lazzari. Giants talking up out there. Schumacher's all set. Here's the next pitch. It's a ball a little bit inside of the knee. Ball two and strike one for Lazzari. Next man due to come up is the pitcher, Ruffing. Schumacher Schumacher has his glove off, rubbing the ball around in his hands. Foul, that's a long lead off at third base. Here's the next pitch from Lazzari.
Pat Malone, cocky right-hander, big
Heavy set fellow. Number 21 is going to pitch for the Yankees. Pat made one appearance so far in the World Series, coming in as a relief man in the ninth inning. And now he's coming in the seventh inning with the game tied up at 4-4. And from Malone's viewpoint, it's his ball game to win or lose. Now Pat is ready to pitch to Joe Moore. Here it is. It's a ball outside, right above his knees. Ball one. Joe Moore up at the plate. Nobody on and nobody out. Here's the pitch. Hit the ball. It's outside at the knee. Ball two. Pat Malone. Heavy set right-handers on the mound for the Yankees with the score tied at 4-4. Joe McCarthy just roughing out for a pinch hitter who struck out. Pitch. Moore drops a high fly into right center field. Selkirk is moving in. DiMaggio's coming over. Selkirk is under it, and he has it for the first down. Face up Bartell. Bartell up at the plate. Right-handed hitter. One gone and nobody on at the seventh. Ball game tied up at 4-4. Now to wind up at the first pitch. There's a high hit foul down the third baseline. Low liner hit hard down the third baseline. It was foul. Another new ball is tossed out to Malone. Pat walks around out there, taking his time, getting ready. Ross tosses it up at third. Ross, Corsetti, Lazzari, and Derrick in the infield. Powell, DiMaggio, and Selkirk in the outfield. Here's a nice pitch to Bartell. Hits a long fly ball back to the left field. Powell is backing up. He's under it. Has it for the second out. Bartell hit a long fly ball back in the left field. He was caught by Powell for the second out. Next man to come up is Perry. Been up three times, so out of here. Here's Bill Terry up. Tom Malone is ready. Here's the pitch to Bill. That's ball outside the knee, a ball. Ball one. Malone takes his time, gets ready out there. He's all set again. Next pitch to Perry. Low and inside a ball. Ball two. Perry is out in the seventh inning for the Giants. With two out and nobody on the bases, and the score tied at 4-4. Getting all ready out there again. There's the windup. Here's the next pitch. Perry takes ball three outside, late five. Throws the ball out to Malone. Pat takes his glove off. Drops the ball up in his hand. Now he's ready. Here's the windup and the next pitch. Hits the strike. Right across his knee. Ball three and strike one. Pat winds up again. Here's the next pitch. Fastball. He hits it back into the wires. Ball three and strike two for Terry. Three and two. That still has a pretty good dip on that fast one. Walks around the grass behind the circle. Now he's walking into the middle of the diamond, stepping up under the rubber. Three and two count on Terry with nobody on board. Two gone. Here's the pitch. Terry hits a little water right back at Malone, the left side of the mound. He picks it up over the first. He leads the out. Malone to Gary, and it retires the side. Now the game is going into the last half of the seventh. All right, Tony.
The Giants are down in order. Pat Malone pitching for the Yanks. As we open the seventh inning, Moore flying out to Selkirk in right center. Bartell flying out to Powell in the left field. And Terry was out to Malone to Garrett. We're going into the last half of the seventh inning. The ball game tied up at 4-0. The Giants scoring three runs in the first and one in the sixth. The Yanks scoring one in the second, one in the third. And tied up the ball game in the sixth by shoving across two runs. 4-0 going into the last half of the seventh. Now the ball game. Last half of the seventh inning coming up. The outfielders getting set. Moore, Ripple, Mellock. Hal Schumacher has pitched a marvelous game today for the Giants. Out there looking over the seat of the catcher.
With airtight support, he still have a lead in this ballgame.
First man to come up is the leadoff man, Frankie Corsetti, who's played some sparkling ball in the series. The play, an all-around play, both in field and at bat, of Frankie Corsetti, has been one of the highlights of the series. Here's Frank up. He's been up three times today. Done once. Virtue of an error. This is low and outside of ball. Ball one. Corsetti struck out twice today. Swinging the Schumacher slant. Now winds up again. Here's the next pitch. Fastball waist high for the call strike. Count is one and one. Nobody on and nobody out at the last half of the seventh. Fifth game of the World Series is tied up at 4-4. Winding up again, here's the next pitch. Outside of the knee, a ball makes it ball two and strike one for Corsetti. Schumacher goes back to the rosin bag. It's all set out there again, steps up onto the rubber now. Corsetti is waiting for the pitch. Wind up, here it is. Fastball, he swung from his heels that time and missed it. And the count is 2-2. Frankie really went around that time, trying to get that ball alive, but he missed it. And it's a 2-2 count on Corsetti. Schumacher takes his time, getting ready. He's winding up again. Here's the next pitch to Frank. Strike three. Struck him out, a big hook right in around his knee. And Corsetti is out on strikes. One gone. Here's the third baseman, Ross. He's been a troublemaker for the Giants all during the series. Red Ross, the Yankee third baseman. Flashy fielder and a good hitter. Got two hits today. First pitch to Ross is right down the middle, knee high for a call strike. Ross has a total of seven hits in the series. Five previous to today's game and two today. Schumacher's ready again. He's winding up. Here's the next pitch to Ross. It's a strike right down the middle that time with a hook on it. He threw him a fastball the first time. He threw him a curve the second time. And it's two strikes on Ross. Schumacher left the ball in his hands. Gets ready out there again. There's the windup, and here's the next pitch. He struck him out. This ball, the big hook right around his knee. Ross is out on strike. Two balls. Here's Joe DiMaggio. Joe struck out twice today. Bounced out to Jackson the other time. DiMaggio's up at the plate. Batting right-handed with two out and nobody on the base. Schumacher's ready to pitch. He hits the line over the shortstop's head at the same pitch. Out of the left center field. Left fielder comes up with it. Back into the infield. He's on his way to second. And he slides and he's safe at second. It's a two-bagger for DiMaggio. A line over the shortstop's head. Bartell leaps into the air to try to head it off, but couldn't. Left fielder Moore picked up the ball off the ground out there in left center field and fired it in, but DiMaggio was in at second base by a comfortable margin and at the two base hit. Now there's a man out second with Lou Gehrig up. Man out second and Lou Gehrig comes up now. DiMaggio on second base. Lou Gehrig is up with two outs. Schumacher gets ready. Draws his arms up in front of him. They're going to pitch to him. Here it is. First pitch is a little bit too low for a ball to Gehrig. And on second base with two gone here in the last half of the seventh. Lou Gehrig is up. He's been up three times and he's made one hit. Here's the next pitch. Strike. Schumacher caught the corner that time. The outside corner at Gary Cleese, and the count is 4-1 and strike one. Ball game is tied up at 4-4. Last half of the seventh inning of the fifth game of the World Series. Hal Schumacher is ready again. Here's the next pitch. Slow ball outside above the knee makes it ball two and strike one. Schumacher pulls his pitching hand up to his mouth. Seemingly is blowing on his hand out there. Now he goes back, touches the rosin bag, puts his hand up to his mouth again. Now he has his glove off, and he's rubbing the ball around in his hand. Now it's been many a spot out here today, and he showed plenty of heart. Getting all set again. He's ready. Here's the pitch.
fastball. He caught the corner on Gehrig again with a strike, and the count is 2-2. Fastball over the outside corner, knee high. It's 2-2 on Gehrig. Gehrig turned around to talk to the umpire and to register a mild squawk. Joe DiMaggio is on second base. The ball game is tied up at 4-4. It's the last half of the seventh. Hal Schumacher is getting his time to get arms up over his head, drops him down. He's ready. Here's the pitch. Outside to me, a ball. Mastuto tried to pull that one in a hurry. Try to make the pitch look good, but he couldn't fool the umpire. And it's kind of ball three and strike two. And now Gus walks out between the plate and the pitcher's mound to talk to Schumacher. Ball three and strike two. Last time up, Gehrig hit a high-bounding ball to Whitehead and was thrown out. The time before that, he struck out with the bases loaded. The first time up, he singled. Then all the way around the third on his single, when Hot let the ball go through his leg. Now it's a 3-2 count on the batter. DiMaggio taking the long lead off of second base. It's the last half of the seventh. Here's the pitch. Inside. Ball four. He walked him. Wild pitch very low and inside. The catcher Mancuso stabbed that ball with his bare hand. It would have been a wild pitch. The man on first and the man on second, and brings up Dickey now. It's two gone. There are two wonderful catchers in this series. Joe Dickey of the Yankees and Gus Mancuso of the Giants. He gets the walk. Two men on. Now Schumacher getting the pitch to Bill Dickey. He got three times today. Popped out, flied out, and struck out. Facing Hal Schumacher now in the last half of the seventh. Here's the pitch. A slow curve. Just missed the corner. Ball low. Ball one, just outside the knee. Schumacher looks back around the infield again. Takes a look at the scoreboard. DiMaggio's on second. Gehrig is on first. There's two gone in the last half of the seventh inning of his fifth game of the World Series. It's a tense moment here in New York. The pitch, fastball below his waist. Just between his waist and his knees. A fastball over the outside corner. And Bill watches his throw by. An umpire firmly shoots his right fist up in the air. And it's a called strike. 1-1 on Bill Dickey now. Yankees great center fielder edging off a second base. Joe DiMaggio. Score is tied at 4-4. Al Schumacher getting ready again. Here's the pitch. He pitched. Drives a big pitch that time around his knees. And the count is ball one and strike two. Al Schumacher pitched a fast one in there that time with a big break on it. Right in around Dickey's knees over the outside corner. And the count is ball one and strike two. Two men on. Two out. Ball one and strike two on the batter. Now Schumacher gets ready again. Here's the next pitch. It's a high foul. Back behind the plate. Mancuso's coming back. He caught it. Dickey fouled out to Mancuso right here below. It's off a little bit to the left. Just was looking right up into the sky right below us there. We can get a good look at him. And he caught that top foul off the bat of Bill Dickey to the higher this side. That's the end of the seventh inning. And I guess, Tony, we're seeing some ball game here today, aren't we?
Certainly are, Bob. Now, if you'd like proof of why the Lincoln Zephyr is tomorrow's car today in performance, appearance, and comfort, ask any Lincoln Zephyr dealer to let you drive one. He'll be glad to. And now in the Yank half of that seventh inning, Corsetti, the first man up, struck out. Rolfe struck out. And Joe DiMaggio made his appearance up the plate, and he smacked the double down over short. Lou Gehrig followed, and he was walked. And then Dickey fouled out to Mancuso. The ball game is tied up at 4-4. We're going into the Giant half of the eighth inning. The Giants this afternoon scored 3 runs in the first and 1 in the sixth. The Yankees scoring 1 in the second, 1 in the third, and then tied up the ball game at 4-4 in their half of the sixth inning when they shoved it off 2 runs. Going into the Giant half of the eighth, and here is Bob Elk. Thank you, Tony. I was Tony Wakeman of W.L. Washington, my associate on the broadcast. Going into the first half of the eighth inning, first man to come up from New York, Little Mel Ott. Ott drove a short hit into left field last time. Well, I want to tell you, if you haven't gathered it for yourself, that this is some ball game. Everybody in the Yankee Stadium is seated on the edge of their chairs. Here's Malone. First pitch is low and outside, a ball to Mel Ott.
Malone pitching. Yankees have used two pitches today, Ruffing and Malone. Next pitch, fastball low and outside to Mellock. Ball two. Pancho Snyder, the guy coach at third, leaps into the air, waving his arms around to fly the metal Malone. That pitch last inning and retired the side and order, moved by Kellen Terry. Here's the next pitch. On hits a high fly in the center field. The Maggio is moving over toward left center. He's under it. Has it for the first out. Mellock flies to DiMaggio in left center field. Here's Ripple. Ripple has a hit and a walk today.
Ball game is tied up 4-4. First half of the game.
Out on the field in the sun is the left fielder Moore. Center fielder Ripples in the shade.
Right fielder's in the shade, been in the shade all afternoon, and the infield is entirely submerged with shade. Sun is just out of the spot in left field. Here's Selkirk up. George has number three in the back of his uniform. Black cap, black stockings. Now he's up there facing Schumacher. First pitch. Fastball over the inside corner, knee high for a called strike on Selkirk. The score is tied at 4-4. Here's the windup on the next pitch. There's a high infield fly. Right in front of the plate, a little bit down the first baseline. Mancuso's under it and caught it. 20 feet down the first baseline, 5 feet inside the line. A high pop fly in third territory is caught by Mancuso, retiring Selkirk for the first out. One gone. Next man to come up is Jake Powell. He flied out, he walked, and he beat out an infield hit. That was the hit on which Jackson made the wild throw. Here's Powell up now. Schumacher's ready. Here's the pitch. Fastball. He swung hard that time. The old sinker. And he missed it for a strike. See the drop on that one? Schumacher's ready again. Here's the next pitch to Powell. Same run, and he struck at it again and missed it. Two strikes. Warren, does he have speed behind that one? Powell says, let's take a look at the ball to the umpire. He throws it in. Seemingly okay, and the umpire, Mr. Furman of the National League, gives it back to the catcher who steps out in front of the plate and throws the ball back to Hal Schumacher. Two strikes on Powell. One out and nobody on the bases in the last half of the eighth. Strike three. Struck him out. He threw a curveball at him that time. Right above his knees over the outside corner. Powell swung and missed, striking out. Two gone. Here's Lazzari. Tony walked the first time, hit into a force play the second time. The third time, he drove a hit into right field on the ground and scored the tying run of the game. Terry batting. Two out and nobody on the base. Here's the pitch. Fastball, low inside, a ball to Lazzari. Schumacher takes a couple of kicks out there at the turf around the pitching rubber. Looks back at the shortstop. Turns around now to face the hitter. Lazzari is up. There's two out here in the last half of the eighth inning of this fifth game of the World Series. Score tied at 4-4. The pitch. Fastball, he hits a high bounding ball to Bartell up with it. There goes the ball over the first base. He's out. Bartell to Terry. And it retires the side. At the end of the eighth inning, the ball game tied up at 4-4. And here's Tony Wick.
Every day you drive your present car, it decreases in value. Take advantage of the Ford dealer's nationwide used car clearance sale now in progress to get a better used car. Look in your local newspaper for special bargains in R&G used cars. They are renewed and guaranteed. In the Yank after eighth inning, Selkirk, the first man up, lined out to a rather sent up the high one in front of the plate. It was taken by Mancuso. Then Powell struck out. The guy was out. Bartell to Terry, retiring the side. We're going in out of the giant half of the ninth inning. The ball game is still tied up. That's 4-0. Now the Yankees are out there on the field. Big fish Pat Malone is looking over a few of the catchers. First man to bat will be the second baseman, Burgess Whitehead. There he is up at the plate. It's the ninth inning of the fifth game of the World Series. Ball game is tied up at 4-4. Now Malone is ready to pitch to Whitehead. He busts one foul off there to the right, a pop-up. Didn't go high enough into the air of the line, but he can get under it. In fact, he followed it so hard and went right over near the giant dugout. There's Pat's buddy Fitzsimmons. Seated down there in the giant dugout, simply watching play. Buddy came up with a beautiful pitch ball game in this World Series, but lost it. 2-1. Malone is ready as the next pitch to Whitehead. There's a long fly ball back into right fielder. The right fielder Selkirk is under it, and he has the ball for the first out. Whitehead hit a long fly to Selkirk for the first out. Brings up Jackson. Jackson up. Here's Jack facing Malone.
clock winding up. Here's the pitch. There's a high foul up into the upper tier of the box seats down the first baseline. One strike on Travis Jackson. One out. Nobody on the bases in the first half of the ninth inning. Ball game tied up at 4-4. Schumacher sits all the way against Ruffing and Malone. Here's the windup in the next pitch. Jackson bumps one right out in front of the plate. Malone picks it up, gets it over to first base. He's out. Malone to Gary. Jackson bunted and was thrown out on a fast play. Malone to Gary. He bunted to the left of the plate. Almost out to the pitching spot. Malone moved to his right, picked it up, and threw him out. With Hal Schumacher getting a strong hand, and the lad certainly deserves it. He pitched a wonderful game out here today. To see win the World Series, the Yankees or the Giants. Couldn't help but feel as this crowd does about Schumacher's pitching performance out here today. First pitch is low, ball one. Pat Malone, right hander on the mound. Here's the next pitch. There's a high foul up into the stands, up here to the left. Ball one, strike one on Schumacher. Four tied at 4-4. Schumacher stands in the batter's box, getting all ready. Ball set, here comes the next pitch. Foul, hit way down the right field line, up into the upper tier. Drops into the lower stand now. Ball one and strike two for Schumacher. Pat Malone walks around out there, takes his time, getting ready. He pitched the seventh, eighth, and the ninth inning so far, and the Giants haven't made a hit off it. That's getting his time again. He's already out there now. Here's the pitch. Strike three. Struck him out. A fastball right around his knee. Schumacher called out on strike. Pat Malone threw in a fastball right around his knees, and he struck him out. That's the end of the first half of the night.
Now we'll pause briefly for station identification. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System.
This is WGN Tribune Square, Chicago.
Giants went down 1-2-3 in their half of the ninth inning. Whitehead flied out to Selkirk. Jackson was out, Malone to Gehrig, and Schumacher struck out. We're going into the Yankee half of the ninth. The ball game tied up 4-4.
First man to bat now for the Yankees in the ninth inning is Pat Malone. Here he comes out. He's greeted with a mixed chorus of boos and applause. Here's Malone coming up. Here's Malone up. Now Schumacher's ready to pitch the bat. He's batting left-handed. First pitch he swung at. Big bat went around that time. Missed it. One strike. Now he turns around and kids with the umpire, Furman. Schumacher's ready again. Here's the next pitch. He tries to hit in the left field. Pat Malone tries to hit over the third baseman's head into left field. Malone singles to left field. A sharp hit to the third baseman's left. A liner over his head. The man on first base for the Yankees and brings up the shortstop, Frankie Corsetti. Man on first base. Nobody out here in the last half of the ninth inning with the score tied at 4-4. The Yankees win this game. The World Series is over. The Giants win. It stands 3-2. Gary comes over to talk to Hal Schumacher. Corsetti is up. He's been up four times today. He reached first once on an error. He struck out three times. Now Schumacher's ready to pitch. First pitch is high and outside. A ball. Ball one. Malone. Single sharply to left field. It starts the last half of the ninth for the Yankees. Game tied up at 4-4.
Schumacher's getting set out there again. Here's the next pitch. He bunts one down the first base line. Perry picks it up, gets it back to second. It's out. Perry to Bartell. Corsetti punted down the first base line. Perry moved in fast, picked up the ball 10 feet inside the first base line, midway between first base and the plate, and forced Malone at second base. Perry to Bartell. Corsetti, of course, is safe at first. Here's Rolf. Red Ruffing up, the left-handed hitter, been up four times today and has made two hits. He beat out a beautiful drag bunt for his second hit today. Fast man on first, there's a throw. He's back safely. Frankie Corsetti attempted sacrifice was turned into a force play, forcing Big Pat Malone at second. Giants could work easily on the play because Malone is a big, slow man. The pitch, Ralph swung right around his knees and missed it. One strike. The ninth inning, Yankees batting with a man on first. The game tied up at 4-4. Fifth game of the World Series. Schumacher touches the rosin bag. Steps back onto the pitching rubber again. It's all set. There's a ground ball between first and second. Whitehead is up with him over to second out. Back over to first. Safe. No double play. Whitehead to Bartell to Perry. It's out at second. Ground ball hits sharply between first and second. Whitehead smothered it. Good to Bartell. Forcing Corsetti at second base. Bartell fired it back to Perry. They try to get his man, a fast man, but Ross is too fast, and they couldn't double him up. So Ross is on first, and the center fielder Joe DiMaggio is up. Joe's been up four times today. Made one hit. He struck out twice. Go to first base. The runner's back in the bag in a hurry. Perry throws the ball back to Schumacher. Going on his kicking hand out there. The air is kind of cool now and crisp here in the Yankee Stadium. There's a throw to first base. Having the fans put their top coats back on. And on first base, and DiMaggio is up. Last half of the ninth inning, Schumacher bearing down. Here's the pitch. Fast ball in a little bit too close. At the waist, ball one on DiMaggio. And Cusco says something to the pitcher, and then closing the ball. Tied up at 4-4. The Yankees let off with a hit. Malone singled, but there's two out now, and a man on first. Ball is on first base. Schumacher's getting his sign again. Next pitch is low and inside. A ball to Joe. Makes it ball two. Joe DiMaggio's up. Joe steps out of the batter's box now. Drives his hands carefully. Now he's getting up in there again. DiMaggio rolled out the first time up to Jackson. The second time he struck out. The third time he struck out. The fourth time he lined a two-bagger over Bartell's head. Schumacher's ready. Here comes the next pitch. He swung and fouled, tipped the ball. Popped out of Gus Francisco's hands. He rolls off there to the right. Ball two and strike one on Joe DiMaggio. Yankees, great center fielder. Next moment here in the Yankee Stadium in New York City. Ball game is in the last half of the ninth inning. It's the fifth game of the World Series. With the Yankees needing only one, needing this game to win. Giants leading this game and two more. Here's the next pitch. DiMaggio takes a fast ball in a little bit too close to the knee. It's ball three, and the count is now 3-1. 3-1 for Joe DiMaggio. Steps out of the batter's box now. Looks over at the dugout. See whether the looks down the third baseline for Colt. Can't tell whether the fake sign is on or whether it's a sign is to hit the first good one. Well, we'll know right away. Hal Schumacher's getting everybody out there. Runner on first base has a short lead. Pitch is low and walks in. Rolling inside. DiMaggio gets the baseline ball. There's Lou Gehrig coming up. Lou Gehrig coming to bat. Two men on for the Yankees. Two outs. Last
top of the ninth inning. Perry is over talking to Schumacher now. There's Bill going back toward first. Well, let's see what Gary gets done today. He had a hit the first time, the second time he struck out, the third time he rolled out, and the fourth time he was caught. Here's Gary up.
Ball game is tied up at 4-4. Red Ruffing on second. Joe DiMaggio on first. Schumacher's ready. Here's the pitch.
Hits the ground ball. The right hand up in it. Over the first base. He fires the ball. Well, here's the ground ball between first and second. Whitehead came up with a two over to Perry. And it retired the side. And now, Tony, will you please take it while I get my nerves back in shape?
Okay, Bob, we were all on the edge of our chairs there. Some of the fans here even covered up their heads with their overcoats. They didn't want to look. Ford V8 economy is traditional Ford all-around economy. Low first cost, low upkeep cost, low operating cost, and low depreciation give you more miles per dollar when you drive a Ford V8. And here's what happened in that ninth inning for the Yankees. Malone, the first man up, knocked one out to left. It was good for a single. Society hit down the first baseline. Perry tossed to Bartell at second. Malone was fourth at second. Ruff hit to Whitehead. He tossed over to Bartell at second. And Corsetti was fourth. Joe DiMaggio walked. Up came Lou Gehrig. He smacked one down to Whitehead, who shoveled up the ball. Tossed it over to manager Bill Terry at first for the foot out. And retiring this side. And what a ball game it is. It's tied up now at 4-4. And we're going into the giant half of the 10th inning. This afternoon, the Giants scored 3 runs in the first, 1 run in the sixth. And the Yanks scored 1 in the second, 1 in the third, and 2 runs in the sixth. We're going in now to the giant half of the 10th inning. And it's tied up at 4-4. Well, all I can hear around here are rumors of who won a ball game. This is the shortest game I've ever seen. Hold up. He slams a fly ball down the left field line. It bounces into the stands, and it's a two-bag hit, according to the ground rule. A two-bagger. A ball that looks down the playing field and then goes into the stands is automatically a two-bag hit, according to baseball rules. A lot of people start hollering home run around here, but no, it's a two-bag hit. Any ball that hits inside, fair in the playing field, and bounces into the stands is automatically a two-bag hit. That rule is very clearly defined, and there's no spot here for dispute. It's a two-bag hit by Joe Moore to start the 10th inning. Here's Bartella. In the excitement here, Tony Wakeman just spilled a cup of coffee on my lap. And it's cold coffee, and it's pretty cold here in the foreground or in the stadium. How is the man on second base? Here's a pitch to Bartell, a bunt down the third baseline. Ruff is in fast over the first base. He's out. What a fast play. Ruff to Missouri. No more is on clears now. The next man to come up is the manager, Bill Terry. He let off that time with a two-bagger down the left field line that bounced into the stand. Then the next man up, Bartell, sacrificed. So there's a man on third now with Perry coming up. Man on third now in the 10th inning. The Yankee infield is drawn in close. Pat Malone is out there on the mound for the Yankees. Ross, Missouri, Cicetti and Gehrig drawn in. Here's a pitch out of Perry. Hits a foul high up into the stands off there to the left. All eyes are turned up, walks the surface of the ball, slips upstairs and drops down into the aisle way down below. The fifth game of the World Series is in the 10th inning. The Giants have Joe Moore on third. Joe came through with his second double of the day. Over the third baseman, Ted way down the line, and bounced into the box seat for the two-bagger. Bartell advancing the third base with a perfect sacrifice. Down the third baseline, a hit drops him up with a fast play. He's got a fast man. So that's the pitcher now in the 10th inning with a man on third. Here's Perry up. Perry today has been hitless 4 times up without anything resembling a hit. At a
taking his time getting ready out there.
Puts a foul again into the stand. Two strikes on Perry. Lou Gehrig leans forward over there, taps his glove with his bare hand, shoots his bare fist up into the air, shouting words of encouragement to Pat Malone. Yankee Stadium just teething with excitement here. What has been the greatest game of the series? Tied up at 4-4 with Joe Moore, the left fielder, on third base, and Bill Perry up. Pitches wide, a fastball, makes it ball one and strike two. Pat Malone looks around at his teammates drawn in close. They all talk it up, shout words of encouragement to him. Gehrig, Luzeri, Corsetti, and Walt. The outfielder's foul is playing Perry way over near the left field line. DiMaggio's playing him in dead center. Selkirk has moved in and gets to Perry in right field. There's one gone and a man on third with the game tied up at 4-4 in the 10th inning. Malone is ready to pitch. Perry takes a low one outside for another ball. The count is 2-2. Next man to come up is Mellott, the giant right fielder. Roth is shouting over there. Corsetti, a regular pepper pot out there in the Yankee infield, keeps up the old chatter. It seems he's been talking incessantly ever since this series started. He's a great player, and he shows plenty of stuff to the fans here in this World Series. Here's a pitch to Perry. Outside, the knee, a ball, makes it 3-2. Wide at the knee, makes it ball 3-2. The umpire is drawing a line now for the Yankees, showing them where that ball went by. Malone and Dickey playing to cut the corner waist high. Up by a Thurman, leans over and draws a line with his finger, showing him that it missed the corner by an inch or two. Pat Malone is standing on the home plate here, right below us, talking to him. The 3-2 count on Perry, who says nothing, of course. But listens to the argument with an attentive ear. Well, gee, this has been a thriller. Boy, now the old staccato copies from the Giants fans. These Giants have put up a fight today. Really put up a battle. Pat Malone is getting ready. Here's the next pitch to Perry. Hits a high fly way out in left center field. Watch the man from third now. DiMaggio catches the ball on the run. Here he's coming in, and he scores. The Giants are leading 5-4. Perry slapped the fly ball into left center field to DiMaggio. He caught the ball on the run from center field, running into left center, and consequently was running toward the third baseline when he caught the ball and had to stop, turn around suddenly, and fire the ball into the infield. But to get a fast man like Joe Moore, especially when you're off balance and out of line to throw the ball, is impossible. Moore scores easily, and the Giants are ahead 5-4. Out of two outs, here's Salada. Pat Malone, all right-hander. Hails from out in Youngstown, Ohio, is on the mound. Heavy cut fellow. Well, the 10th inning of a whale of a ball game here. Here comes the next pitch. Fastball to Little Mel. Going outside, a ball. Ball one. Pat Malone takes his time out there again. Getting ready. Giants have scored here on a hit, a sacrifice, and a long fly. Hot steps away, but pitches right over the plate. Ball strike. The count is 1-1. Ball one and strike one. That hit of Joe Moore's is the only hit that the Giants have made off of Malone in 4 innings. That is winding up again. Here's the next pitch. Over the plate, he hits a high top fly. Third base to Ruff is coming down toward the plate. Under it, has the ball 15 feet inside the third base line. Exactly midway between the plate and third base, and it retires the side. Giants go into the lead in the first half of the 10th inning by a score of 5-4. And now there'll be a brief pause for station identification. This is the 5th game of the World Series. It's now an extra inning from the first half of the 10th. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System.
This is WGN Tribune Square, Chicago.
surprises we had in that inning. The first man up, Moore, sent one down the left field line. It took a hop, bounced into the boxes. Everybody thought it was a home run, but according to the ground rules, it was good for a double. Bartell followed. He hunted down the third baseline. Ross, the inside, doubled up, shot it over to Lou Gehrig for the putout, and Moore raced down to third on the play. And up came Terry, flied out to DiMaggio, and Moore scored after the catch, putting the Giants out in front 5-4. Now out the next man up, Foster Ross, retiring to side. We're going into the last half of the 10th inning. Score, the Giants 5, the Yankees 4, and turning you back over to Bob Ellis.
Thank you, Tony. Here's the last half of the 10th inning coming up now, ladies and gentlemen. First man to bat is Phil Dickey, the catcher. My nerves are afraid to a frazzle here today in this fifth game of the World Series. This game and the Fitzsimmons game have really been tortured. The other games, of course, like the Giants game and the first game, and the other games were all one-sided. Here's the first pitch to Bill Dickey. It's over the plate and hit the ground ball to Terry. Batter knocks it down, picks it up, it's over the first. He's safe at first. He beat it out for a hit. Safe at first. Hit a ground ball to Terry. Well back of the bag. Terry knocked the ball down and couldn't find it. Recovered the ball and got it to the pitcher Schumacher, who covered first base, and it's a hit. The official scorer gives Dickey a hit. Last half of the 10th inning. Still Dickey goes on down the first baseline, a high bounding ball, hit very hard. Terry slapped the ball down to his right a couple of feet, couldn't find the ball, looked to his left first. Finally, they hollered at him. He picked it up and threw the ball to Schumacher, who came over fast, but he missed the man. And the official scorer, Quidditch, Dickey with a hit. Here's Selkirk up. Giants are ahead 5-4. Last half of the 10th. Pitch. He swung all the way around that time, trying to get a ride, and he missed it. Well, it's plenty dangerous up there. Outfielders moved around to the right for him. Schumacher takes his time. He's getting all ready out there again. Here's the next pitch. Hits a high foul right behind the plate. Schumacher is backing up. Here he is looking right up into the sky, and he has it for the first out. He caught the ball to the left of the plate and about 25 feet from the plate. Just to the left, that is right in line with the first base line. Moving about 25 feet to the left of the plate, right in line with first base, about 25 feet away. It's an easy high pop foul for Mancuso, and there's one draw. Down on first base, and foul is up. Down first base is a short lead. Al's getting a sign out there. He's all set. Hits. He swung hard that time. Trying to connect with that hook of Schumacher's, and he missed it. And over the outside corner, knee high with a very big break on the ball.
Schumacher walks back and touches the rosin bag. Yankees use two pitchers today, Ruffing and Malone. Schumacher has pitched all the way for the Giants. Game is in the last half of the 10th inning with Powell up. Next pitch, low outside, a ball. Mancuso cocks his arm, ready to fire the ball to first base, but the runner moves back to the bag in a hurry. Schumacher's getting his sign out there again. Runner on first base is a short leadoff. Powell, the left fielder, is batting. Here's the pitch. Inside, high, close to the batter. Makes it ball two and strike one for Jake. Jake has made one hit today. Struck out, flied out, and walked. Schumacher walks back, touches the rosin bag. Powell is out of the batter's box. A runner going out for Dickey. Speed. Used to be in the American League with Cleveland. We just recalled from the International League. Seeds is running for Dickey. Seeds, an outfielder. This is the same Bob Seeds used to be with Cleveland. Out of ball, two and strike one. The pitch, he hits a high fly into left field. Left fielder's coming in over near the line. He's under it. Has it for the second out. Powell slide out to Joe Moore. One more out now. This ball game will be over. Here's Lazare coming up. field line. Moore moved over fast and in fast and caught the ball, standing under it. Easy catch for the second out. Giants are leading 5-4 in the last half of the 10th inning. Hal Schumacher has withstood the barrage of these Yankee guns here today in the Yankee Stadium, come up with a marvelous pitching performance. Ruffing also pitched a fine, creditable game. And on first base, here's the pitch. Right over the plate. Of course, from the Giants' viewpoint, when the Giants pitcher stops the Yankees, he stops more. The way these Yankees have been hitting and slugging that ball, the Giants haven't been hitting. Bob Seeds on first base. Running for Dickey. Schumacher's getting his sign out there again. Lazaria's up. There's two going here in the last half of the 10th. Here comes the next pitch. There's the runner going down to second base. He's out of second base, and the game is over. The pitch was a ball. The runner going down to second base was out. The game is over, and the Giants defeated the Yankees by a score of 5-4. Now I'm going to have Tony listen to the official score on that play. The pitch was outside, knee high. The batter did not swing. There were two strikes on Lazaria. He did not swing. And I'm sure that it was a ball. The runner going down was out of second base and was thrown from that Matthew to Whitehead. And that out of second base was the out that retired the side and ended the fifth game of the World Series. The pit out of second base. Steve's attempting to go down on the pitch, which was outside. It was a ball. It was very close at the knee. He was going down, and he slid into second base and was out. Mancuso to Whitehead retires the side, and the fifth game of the World Series is over. The winning pitcher, of course, is Hal Schumacher, and the losing pitcher is Pat Malone. What a wonderful game you're getting today. This is Bob Elson, who's had the pleasure of describing the play-by-play for you. I do hope that you've all enjoyed our story of the game. Now here's my associate, Tony Wakeman of Station WOL in Washington, and I think Tony will agree with me that we've seen some battle here today.
Well, Bob, we certainly have. It was a grand, grand ball game. The Giants started out by scoring 3 runs in the first inning. The Yankees came back, scored 1 in the second and 1 in the third. Then the Giants got out in front by a 4-2 count in the sixth inning, and the Yankees tied up the ball game in their half of the sixth by shoving across 2 runs. And it was nip and tuck going into the 10th inning. The Giants put across 1 run. And, of course, the Yanks failed to score in their half of the 10th inning. And the ball game ended up. The New York Giants, 5 runs, 8 hits, and 3 errors. The Yankees, 4 runs, 10 hits, and 1 error. I'll repeat that for you. The Giants, 5 runs, 8 hits, and 3 errors. The Yankees, 4 runs, 10 hits, and 1 error. And another World Series game goes into the record book. The Ford Motor Company and the Ford and Lincoln Zephyr dealers of America have brought you these play-by-play descriptions of the 1936 World Series game. The play-by-play announcer this afternoon, Bob Elson of WGN Chicago, and the color was given by Mutual State commentator Gabriel Heater of WOR New York. Tomorrow afternoon at 1:15, the Ford and Lincoln Zephyr dealers of America will broadcast the 6th game of the 1936 World Series. We hope that you'll be with us then. And in the meantime, watch the bullets go by. Tony Wakeman speaking. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System.
This is WGN Tribune Square, Chicago.